So let's see the Pixel Experience ROM Android 11 on my i1 review. Let's see the about phone. As you can see, the Android version is Android 11. The security version is of November 5 and the kernel version is 4.9 kernel. As the name of the ROM suggests, Pixel Experience, you don't get many customization in this ROM. Say in network and internet, you get normal settings, but in mobile network, Volt is somehow disabled, but the LTE is working. Then apps and notification, here you get conversations. Then in notifications, you get bubbles. As the Android 11 feature of notification bubbles, you can enable it. Then you can see the screen time and in advance, your default app, permission manager, wireless emergency alerts and special app permissions. Then in battery, here you get a battery saver. You can choose the extreme battery saver. Here it asks that when to use. Then essential apps for battery saver. When you turn on the battery saver, say when you turn on it, see all the third party apps get disabled. See, as the name suggests, extreme battery saver. Then in display, you get brightness level. Then you can turn on the dark theme and also schedule it. Then night light, adaptive brightness, then styles and wallpaper. Here you can choose the accent color, font, styles, etc. and wallpaper. Then grid. And grid is the number of apps shown on the home screen. And in advance, you get screen timeout, font size, display size, screen saver, lock screen, double tap to wake, and device in VR. Then in sound settings, you can choose the volume. Then here you get live captions. In live caption you can enable it. Then you can choose the language, high profanity, show sound labels, live caption and volume control, and caption calls. Then in media, you can hide the media player after session is ended. Then then shortcut for prevent ringing, and in advance you get a normal options, and down here you get the MI sound enhancer. And that you can choose the headphone type and choose a preset for headphone. And in privacy, you can get privacy manager. So you can choose the permissions and show password, notification on lock screen, and device personalization services. And in advance, you get app content, autofill service for Google, etc. Then in location, you can allow a location for a specific app. Then privacy and location, and security. You don't get the face unlock option. You get the fingerprint. See, I'll show you. It's very fast. As you can see, it's very fast. And in system, you get gestures. That is, swipe finger for notification and quickly open the camera. Then system navigation, here you get the gesture navigation and 3 button navigation. Then prevent ringing, power menu customizations, etc. These are the customizations. In this you get the default launcher. See home settings, you don't get many customizations. Here you get customization address, notification dots at a glance, app icon for home screen, swipe to access the Google app suggestions, and allow the home screen rotation. Here you get the stock camera, but you can install the Google camera, which I have installed. Let's see the Geekbench score. See in Geekbench, the single core score is 166. and the multi-core score is 960. The ROM is very smooth. Now let's see the coils are working or not. The 198. As you can see, the coils are working fine. And the battery of this ROM is pretty good. I got around 6 hours to 7 hours of battery life. And the installation of the process is exactly same. I've already made a video on it. If you haven't watched, the link is in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching. I'll meet you in the next one.